Welcome to ThreatLive Stadium here in New York, home of the Tyrants. Well, they really cleaned up Times Square, huh? I kind of miss the sea of wandering zombies and the stench of the open zombie landfills. And they had this nice all-you-could-shoot zombies in a barrel arcade, I remember.
Yeah, those are the good old days, Grim.
Now it's just a tourist attraction. Peep shows and organized crime. Remember, in the MFL, we encourage you to play with your food. He's probably lining up against you. The Malice Hellboys take on the New Yuck Tyrants. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Hello again, everybody. Grim Blitzrow here, along with Brickhead Mulligan.
That's me.
And his mutant hobbit head that lives on his shoulder, Bricks Jr.
How about you shut the fuck up?
Well played, Jr. Moving on. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. The defense is on its heels. Great run on that play. And it's first and 10. That's a 6-yard gain. And that'll be second down and 4. He's supercharged and can electrocute any opposing... Oh, and the defender knocked the ball out when he was in midair. It is a fumble indeed.
Fumble Banji, the new game from Wilton Crabtree.
He's at the 20. The 10. And he rumbles into the end zone for the score.
I hope he's not going to dance now.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like... Here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10.
I've seen this guy run through a brick wall. He loves pain. First down.
And it's first and 10. Ah, the strawberry field's dirty trick. As my mentor Hunter used to say, I don't advocate drugs, alcohol, narcotics, or incense. Nice pass. That catch is good for 6 yards. And that'll be second down and 4.
The way a rolled up dollar bill sticking out of flimsy Lohan's nose hits a mare in Lost Wages, Nevada.
And it's first and 10.
Ooh, hope he's got a good chiropractor.
Second down in inches. For the first down. First and 8 to go.
Oh.
Second down and a mile. And they run it for a couple of yards. Third down and the punter is warming up. A lot of yards on that pass play. They'll need to regroup quickly. It's not short, but this one shouldn't give the kicker any trouble.
Unless he collapses under pressure and never makes another kick again.
It's good. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Refuses to go. Boom! And it's first and 10. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. First down and a mile. Oh, with the brutal hit. And it's first and 10. Second down in a very lot.
Hot one, hot two, hot three.
Nicely done for a first down. And it's first and 10. Comes the extra point attempt. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five. First and 10. Oh, with a punishing hit. And that'll be second down and 4. That's the end of quarter one. Well, the good news is there's still time to make it a game.
And there's still time to get a beer.
And that'll be second down and 4.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking? I mean, when they're not yawn.
And it's first and 10.
One time, when I was playing, a guy hit me so hard, I went into a doctor. tunnel. Thought I saw my grandparents waving at me in the light. Turns out it was just the visitor's tunnel that he knocked me into, and it was the paramedics waving fingers in my face.
He caught it, and nothing was going to stop him from getting into the end zone. Does anyone have a rule book? Because that sounds like he's making stuff up.
Chair so you can reach the table without spilling your food, idiot.
And this is a first and they've had enough. The offense jumps on sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. Great catch for a big game.
But still not enough for a first. Even I'm frustrated, and I'm a team agnostic.
Second down and five. Just a great run for a touchdown. Well, why go for one when you could go for two?
It's always been my philosophy, but Bricks can't even get one. Oh, you're talking about points.
The QB threads the needle for 2 points.
Hey, Grim, you ever dance with the devil in the pale moonlight?
This isn't the devil, Brick. Just one of them.
Oh, that don't make it any less scary.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. First and 10. Good thing they had a good testing in the MFL. He just ran into the line at the DMV.
And guess what, Grim? That line ain't moving.
Yeah, that was kind of my point, Bricks. Second down and 10. And that pass play is good for 8 yards. Third and 2. Defense goes warp speed, and he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can see that, Grim.
Any mistakes here, just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights. Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. First and 10. The ground game should be their bread and butter. A gain of 8 right there.
Hey, anyone seen that Korean kid yet with my barbecue?
Last time I ordered Korean, I got Kim Jong-il.
Oh, look at him. He's rumbling and stumbling. He could go all the way. And it's first and 10. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him.
Wow, look at that freak go. He's unstoppable.
And he runs it in for the touchdown. Well, it's all fun and games until he tries breakdancing.
Yep, with skeletons, it's always more literal.
They want more points, so they're going for two. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. And it's first and 10. And he runs it for 4 yards. Second down and 6.
I ate a piece of licorice once and got a shot like that.
It wasn't licorice, you idiot. It was the frayed cords of the leaf blower.
Well, it was a red cord and it looked like licorice. The point is... I forgot my point.
And it's first and 10. Oh, great tackle! When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about bad hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
First and 2. And the crowd goes wild! Touchdown! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing, but their team has a chance to respond. And it's first and 10. And they'll keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. And they take their first time out.
How predictable. Surprise us next time. Call the timeout during halftime.
Second and 3.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
And the offense quickly calls their second timeout. That's how you do it.
Do what?
It's first and ten. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim.
Timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You gotta use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
Well, this kick is no guarantee.
Sure it is. If he misses, he's fired. Guaranteed.
The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Looks like he'll be able to run this one back if he's not terrified for his life.
He is, but he's got no choice.
Ooh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. And it's first and ten. That's a gain of 7 yards on the catch. Nicely done. It's a close battle as the quarter ends. Halftime is brought to you by those caring folks at Monsatan Industries. They make the world a better place by making the government tell you it is. We're at the start of the third quarter in a nail biter. The teams line up for the second half kickoff. When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's first and ten. Second down and more than the QB would like. Oh, a great catch, and he picks up a new set of downs. And it's first and ten. Holds him to a 4-yard pickup there. Second down and six. And then catch will fall as a team sport, and that's why you should never think about mine unless it's that kind. First and ten. And that'll give them four more downs to punish the defense. And you better believe they will. And it's first and ten. And he just nailed him right on the numbers for a touchdown. If you go frame by frame, you can see the cover of my son's death metal album.
Yeah, baby. Fill up the horns.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called sitters then.
The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
Oh, with the brutal hit.
I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him, not to mention my kneecaps. My loan shark is very anal about collecting my money on time, Grim.
And that's some good old-fashioned downhill running as he picks up 9 yards on the play. And that'll bring up second and one. First and 10. And he picks up 8 yards on a strong run. Second down and 2. Catch the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. And it's first and 10. And into the end zone for a touchdown. Once he got his hands on that pass, he was off to the races. Come to the line trying to tie this up with 2 points.
And if they don't, things are going to get weird and desperate on their sideline.
Hey, give them more credit. Well, that 2-point conversion attempt failed miserably. I mean, that was just terrible. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
What it feels like to have your teeth removed without Novocaine.
If I had all my teeth knocked out like that, I'd have them made into dice, Grim. It'd be fun to gamble with my own teeth.
Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? Second down and 9. Catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. Warp speed engaged.
What are you trying to place your third thing?
He broke free and has open field in front of him. For the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chick wearing a wig.
Good mute.
That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. It's first and ten. Oh, devastating hit. You ever get hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Second down in a very lot. That, my friends, was an all-pro MFL hit. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. Third down and eight. Down, and the offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers. Got crushed.
Oh boy, they're going for it. This could get uglier than the baby resulting from an orcish family reunion.
Man, these guys are some high rollers, and they just won the pot. That's a first down. First down and three. Oh, what a punishing hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size. Because he just walked all over him. Second down and two. They've called a zap attack. The Buffalo defense better watch out. The quarterback just threw a murder ball. Oh, great catch. And that's a touchdown. Touchdown. Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth seven.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They just be
straight through the uprights. They need a good return here to set up the offense. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
Was a bone crusher right there, folks. And it's first and ten. Has only two running backs left, and the defense is licking their lips.
I think they want to hit those last two runners for this outman.
And it's first and ten. He took a beast boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponents.
I want to take a beast boost injection, too.
Now, that is weird side effects, Bricks. Man, he hit that line the way your wife wife hits the all-you-can-eat buffet of crabapple trees, Bricks.
You're telling me? She ate 47 Salisbury steaks one time. Thought she had food poisoning. Turns out her low intestines just exploded.
No, that's a relief, because there's nothing worse than food poisoning.
You're telling me?
Gets the ball, get the first down, and don't die. See, it's really a simple game when it comes down to it. First down and 9. Pickup of about 3 on that play. Second down and 6. Third down, and the punter is warming up. Talk about Butterfingers, he should have had that one. Most kickers should be able to make this one.
But will this kicker make it? Find out next time on MFL Game Day.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Oh, and he looks like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my offseason.
And it's first and 10, and they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down and a mile. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. And that player has warp speed. He's the bullet, and the offense is the target. Oh, great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. Third down, and, well, good luck.
Hot one, hot two.
Well, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. He boomed that one. Let's see if they can get a return. He's got the ball now and is going to try and score. Oh, what a brutal hit. And it's first and 10. Drills one in for the first down. The defense calls their first timeout to save some clock.
I save clocks too, Grim. My wife hates them. They take up the whole garage.
Wait, what? You're married?
It's complicated.
Oh, man, he really won.
Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into...
The defense is leaving the team with just one timeout, so they better bring the ball back gift-wrapped.
Is it time for a ribbon or a ball, Grim?
Maybe if they use their last timeout. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. no more timeouts. The D needs a stop. This is intense.
No, Grim. Camping is intense. Get it?
Idiot.
And it's first and ten. This guy's going to get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. Second down and ten. Here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And the offense goes into a hurry-up to pick up the pace of the game. Second down and long. Well, that play didn't work. He'll have to rethink that. Third down and the punter is warming up.
I'm pretty sure my baby sister can throw further than that. But she doesn't have to play against goddamn monsters.
And the offense fails on that play. And that's the end of the game, barring any miracles. The Tyrants are defeated and walk away losers. They battled hard, but didn't have enough to get it done.
They choked like a bunch of banana choking chimp chumps choking on a bag of chimp dicks.
Did you just say choking on a bag of chimp dicks?
Yeah.
God, that was beautiful. Once again, the folks at Evil SM thank our viewing audience and the Mutant Football League for allowing us to telecast this sports presentation. This is Grim Blitzrow with Brickhead Mulligan and Bricks Jr. signing off.
Today's game was brought to you by Comcrack Entertainment. They're not happy until you're not happy.